Friends, welcome. I welcome you to my channel. Today I am going to take up design of screw fasteners. In which you are likely to get a problem on design of bolt or stud. Now, this bolt or studs or screw fasteners, they are temporary fasteners. They can be removed whenever we want without damaging the parts, and again they can be reassembled. So it is called as temporary fastener. Now, here when they ask us to design a bolt or a stud, what we have to find is nominal dia. It is denoted by D in some this thing. In some books it is called DO, that is outer dia, nominal dia. Okay, whatever it is, nominal dia is what we have to find out. Now, the basic formula for design of a screw fastener is P, that is load. It can be called as P or W, or in some design data handbooks they call it as F. This P load is equal to N, that is number of bolts, into pi DC square by 4 into the permissible tensile stress. Here P is the load in Newton, N is number of bolts collectively or number of studs collectively taking the load, and DC is the core diameter, the diameter at the core of the thread, at the bottom of the thread, that is where it is the weakest, and that should be the area that should be taken. This is called as core area, and this is permissible tensile stress. Because they are subjected to tensile load, this area into stress will be equal to load. This is the basic formula. Now, from this formula, we can get, if we know N and number of bolts, permissible tensile stress and load, then we can get the core area. Core area, that is, this is called core area. That is, it can also be written as N into AC into rho t. So, if you get this core area, then you have a table in your design data handbook from which you can select its nominal diameter. Or if the nominal diameter is given, they may ask you to find the stress that is induced in the bolt, or they may ask you to find out the number of bolts required. So depending upon that, basically this is the formula that is used. Now this P load can be, there are two types of load that are acting. Now, for example, in hydraulic cylinders or IC engine cylinders, we use these studs. There, the cover of the cylinder is fixed to the cylinder by means of a number of bolts or studs. Here, to make the joint steam tight so that no leakage is there, we use sometimes copper gaskets, or some gaskets are used. Then, the load that is acting there will be given by this formula, P1 plus KP2. This is, P1 is called the initial load due to tightening of bolts per bolt, and this P2 is called external load, both in newtons, this and this both in newtons, external load, that is due to the pressure that is there inside the cylinder, what external load is there acting in this thing. This K is called a factor. It depends upon the nature of the gasket that we have used. If it is a soft gasket, copper gasket, for example, K will be 0.5. This you can get again from the design data handbook you can get. Now, if they haven't said anything about this K, then P will be just the external load. This can be per bolt. per bolt or per stud you can take in newtons. Then you can avoid this N. P is equal to area into tensile stress. So you will get the area. Once you get the area from the table, you can select the nominal dia of the bolt that is required, and we can say the design is over. Now we will take up a few examples here to know how to do them. I'll take up the first problem. That is, first problem will be from the question bank. I am taking problem number 4. I'll take problem number 4 here. It goes like this. An I bolt is to be used for lifting a load of 60 kN. An I bolt is required to lift, is to be designed for lifting a load of 60 kN. Find the nominal dia of the bolt if the tensile stress is not to exceed 100 MPa. Assume coarse threads. Right. So this is the problem number. Load. Here P is 60 kN direct. This is the external load. No internal, this initial load due to tightening is not there. If it is not given, just P is 60 kN or 60,000 newtons. And the allowable tensile stress is 100 MPa, which is nothing but 100 Newton per mm square. 1 MPa is nothing but 1 Newton per mm square only. Whether it is MPa or Newton per mm square, it doesn't make a difference. Now, what he says is find the dia of the bolt. Now, Ni bolt means number of bolts is 1. Ni bolt means the number of bolts is 1. See, this I bolt will be something like this. An I bolt will have a circular ring and it will have threads here. It will have threads here. Screw threads. The threads are usually metric threads that are used. Now, this will be in heavy machinery. In the casing of the machinery, this will be screwed. And for shifting the machinery from one place to another by means of overhead cranes, we use hooks in this, and the machine will be lifted and it can be shifted to any place we want. So, this type of bolt is called as an I-bolt. I-bolt. And we are to find out its nominal dia means here. This is nominal dia. This is what you call the core dia. This is called the core dia at the bottom of the thread. The external dia is called nominal dia or outer dia or major dia. They all mean the same thing. So it is 1 bolt. Now this is the load, that is the external load. Now the formula to be used is P is equal to core area into permissible tensile stress. So core area will be equal to P by tensile stress. Then this will be 60,000 divided by 100. So this will be 600 square mm. This area is required for this bolt. If bolt requires, if this is the load and this is the stress, then this gives you the area that is necessary. If you know the area, you go to the design data handbook. In the design data handbook, you have the here you have this column stress area in square mm. We have got the stress area in square mm as 600 mm is required. So this is in the last column, you have stress area here. I am not getting this 600 mm here. We have 561. After that, the next one is 694. Now, I should have 600 square mm area is required here. 600 square mm is not there. I have to select the next higher value of area. Higher value of area here in this table, it is 694. The size of the bolt corresponding to this area is 694 is M33. M means metric threaded. The 33 means it is the nominal dia of the bolt is 33 mm. So this is the corresponding bolt size, and the pitch of the threads is 3.5. If you want, you can write like this into 3.5. This means it is metric threads. This is the diameter, nominal dia of the bolt in millimeter, and this is the pitch of the threads that is used again in millimeter. So this is the answer for this. You can write from design data handbook, I have selected M33 by 3.5 volt, 3.5 size bolt, I bolt, for the purpose of lifting the given load. You can write like this and do the problem. This will be for 7, 8 marks, 9, 10 marks, like that one problem can be asked. I think you have understood it. Problem number 5. Determine the safe tensile load for bolts of M20 and M36. Assume that the bolts are not initially stressed and take the safe tensile stress as 200 MPa. So here, problem number 5, he is asking us, he has given the size of the bolt. There are two bolts. One is M20 is one bolt. M20, that is metric threaded, this is problem number 5, metric threaded 20 mm nominal dia, 5, the other one is M36, metric threaded 36 mm dia, nominal dia bolt is there. Assume the bolts are not initially stressed, that means there is no initial load, P1 is not there, only the external load is there. What external load it can support, what external load this can support, and what external load this can support, separately we have to find out. The material for both is same, and the permissible stress is 200 MPa. Now what we have to do is, again the formula remains the same here. It is a single bolt. Single bolt, so load is equal to core area into this thing. For the first bolt, what is the core area? You can get the core area from the table here, from the table in the design data handbook. You can get M20. For M20, AC is 245. Square millimeter, and for M36 the core area is 817 square mm, 817 square mm, this is given. So for the first one, P is equal to AC, that is 245 into 200, that means it will be 490 followed by two zeros. If you multiply, that is so many newtons, or it can be given, if you want you can give it in kilonewtons. If you give in kilonewtons, it will be 49 kilonewton. That is, this divided by 1000 will give you the value in kilonewtons. So this bolt of size M20 can take an external load of 49 kilonewtons. The second bolt, that is same formula again, P is equal to AC into rho T, that is 817 into 200, so that will be 1634. 34 followed by two zeros, so many newtons, because this is in mm square and this is in newton per mm square, you get it in newtons. Now if you divide it by 1000, you can convert it into kilonewton. So this is 163.4 kilonewton. It can take greater load because it has greater diameter, that means it has got greater area, so it can take greater load, whereas this has lesser area, lesser diameter, so it can take a lesser load only. So that is the load it can take. So this is how it should be done. Next, one more problem. An engine cylinder is 300 mm in dia, that is problem number 7 I am taking. An engine cylinder is 300 millimeter in dia, problem number 7. An engine cylinder is 300 mm in diameter, I'll call it as capital D, 300 mm dia, and the steam pressure is maximum steam pressure, small p, usually we use small p, is 0.7 newton per mm square. Full stop. If the cylinder head is held by 12 studs, n is 12, find the size, find the dia of the bolt. Assume safe tensile stress as 28 MPa, 28 newton per mm square or mega pascals. So this is the problem. Now here, once again, there is no stress due to initial tightening of the bolts, that is not there, P1 is not there, only P2 is there, that is external load is there. Here, see, this is the cylinder, cylinder block, this is the cylinder block, now this is the casting, now inside this there will be steam will be there, this is another casting, this is called cylinder head or cylinder cover. Now here this is D, dia of the cylinder, it is subjected to a pressure here, steam is there, this is a steam cylinder, there will be pressure. If you simply place that cylinder cover there, it will fly away. We should prevent that. So what we do, we use a number of studs here, and they are, if you see from the top, it will be like this. Now these bolts are studs. Stud means they are arranged on a circle. Here there will be holes. Usually the number of studs that are used will be multiples of 3 or 4 so that the circle can be divided equally without much difficulty. So there are 12 holes, so 12 studs, they are taking the load. There is no initial load due to tightening. So P is external load on the bolts or external load on the cylinder head. External load on cylinder head, this you have to calculate. How you calculate? Area of cylinder into maximum pressure inside the cylinder. So area of cylinder will be pi d square by 4. They have given the diameter of the cylinder. Maximum pressure, you can call that as P max or simply P. So pi into 300 square divided by 4 into 0.7. So this will give you the load that is acting on the this thing in newtons. Let us take the calculator. So pi into 300 square into 0.7 divided by 4. So you can take it as 49,480 newton. So this is the load, this is the external load that is coming. There is no initial load, so this itself will be taken as the design load to design it. So for this load we have to design those studs. Now we take this P is equal to N into core area into permissible tensile stress. Here we have to find out the core area of one bolt. The load is being taken collectively by all the bolts there. So we have to take this is the area of one bolt into number of bolts will give you the total area that is resisting the load. So from this we have to find out the core area first. So core area AC will be equal to the load which we have found out divided by N into this. So 49,480 divided by N is 12 and this is 28 newton per mm square. So we get what do we get? This answer is here divided by 12 divided by 28 gives me the core area that is 147.26 square mm. This is the core area required to do this. Now what I do from the design data handbook, I take the design data handbook, I will come to the last column here, area 147. Now 147 is not there. I have 115. After 115, 157 is available. So for 157, the size selected from design data handbook, you can write for this core area, I have selected a bolt of M16 by 2 mm pitch. So a studs of M16 by 2 are selected from the design data corresponding to the core area calculated. If you write like that, the problem is done. So this is how the problem is to be done. I hope you have understood this, how to do it. And I will move on to the next, this thing, that is design of riveted joints. After this, we have to take up the permanent fasteners, rivets come under permanent fasteners. I will move on to that in the next clip.